So is that what you're saying? You're saying that these advertised 5 days of treatment and you're done with SBRT is actually real?
There's randomized data.
I know, but this is, you know, we don't have a lot of randomized data. We have some. So I'm just
you noticed I said 4 treatments. 5 treatments is most frequently used because they get more money. We developed our own technique because we were reproducing our experience with HDR. The way the reimbursement was set up for stereotactic body radiotherapy is that the per treatment charge is greater than a conventional IMRT charge, but they capped it. They said, we will pay you SBRT for no more than 5 treatments. So many doctors said, okay, I'm gonna do 5 treatments because you get paid for each treatment. We did not change, we meaning some of us in our institution, did not change because I didn't change because I could get paid for 5. I used what we knew, what we learned based on what we were doing. So
right.
I used 4. I treat Monday, Tuesday, Thursday, Friday, or Thursday, Friday, Monday, Tuesday. Give 1 day off in the middle.
And you believe that, like in other cancers, this will ultimately show it to be, for some patients, equal in efficacy to going weeks and weeks of radiation treatment.
Okay, look at the data.
No, I'm just saying, I'm not questioning it, I'm just asking.
Yeah, well, I mean, I'm a data person. So, you know, Jackson has a paper review article with 6,000 patients. Keyshawn has an article with other, you know, we wrote a paper on unfavorable intermediate risk and high risk patients. This paper is on PSA kinetics, right? So one of the things you look for when you're comparing forms of radiation is, what does the PSA do? We know, we published years ago, that if you took a patient and you compared, we took low risk patients and we compared those patients that got conventional external beam radiation, dose escalated to brachytherapy, what did we see? We saw 2 big differences. One is that if you did serial MRIs with spectroscopy, you actually measured the metabolism of the gland. The gland was more atrophic after MRI. Choline citrate ratios that are normally high, they're more likely to have complete metabolic atrophy with brachytherapy. Yeah. And the median PSA, when you look at a patient treated with external beam radiation, after a number of years, 3 to 5 years, the average PSA is around 0.4. Okay. But if you look at those patients that are treated with brachytherapy and LDR implant, our median PSA is less than 0.1. Mm-hmm. So there's less metabolism, both normal and cancer, and the PSA is substantially lower with brachytherapy. Now, it appears that HDR is just about the same. Maybe LDR might be a little bit lower. That means the PSAs may actually be a little bit lower. But again, there's patient selection differences. I tend to, the higher risk, higher volume patients tend to get treated with HDR. So more recently, people have done, and Keyshawn has done a lot of this work, and we've done some of this work. We've compared the PSA level and the rate at which the PSA went down with SBRT versus HDR, and it appears to be similar. So if you give the same doses to the same volumes using the same fractionation and the PSA does the same thing, if it swims like a fish and it smells like a fish and it tastes like a fish, it's a fish, I'm convinced that HDR and SBRT, if given, now again, I don't use the fractionation that these people use that are doing these 5 fractions. I'm not saying there's anything wrong with it. I'm saying that our fractionation and our dose volume histograms are done to match HDR. So in our hands, I believe 4 fractions of SBRT are roughly equivalent to 4 fractions of HDR.